Thessalonians, Rishon. The first epistle of Apostle Paul to the Thessalonians. Paul and Silenok and Timotheus unto the called out assembly of the Thessalonians, which are in Yahuwah the Father and in Adonai Yahusha HaMashiach. Grace be unto you and peace from Yahuwah our Father and Adonai Yahusha HaMashiach. We give thanks to Yahuwah the Father always for you all, making mention of you in our prayers, remembering without ceasing your work of belief and labor of love and patience of hope in our Adonai Yahusha HaMashiach, in the sight of Yahuwah and our Father, knowing, brethren, beloved, your election of Yahuwah. For our Besor came not unto you in word only, but also in power and in the Ruach HaKodesh, and in much assurance, as ye know what manner of men we were among you for your sake. And ye became followers of us and of Adonai, having received the word in much affliction with joy of the Ruach HaKodesh, so that ye were examples to all that believe in Macedonia and Achaia. For from you sounded out the word of Adonai, not only in Macedonia and Achaia, but also in every place your belief in Yahuwah is spread abroad, so that we need not to speak anything. For they themselves show of us what manner of entering in we had unto you, and how you turned to Yahuwah from idols to serve the living and true Yah, and to wait for his Son from heaven, whom he raised from the dead, even Mashiach Yahusha, which delivered us from the wrath to come. For yourselves, brethren, know our entrance in unto you, that it was not in vain, but even after that we had suffered before, and were shamefully entreated, as you know, at Philippi, we were bold in Yah to speak unto you the Besorah of Yahuwah with much contention. For our exhortation was not of deceit, nor of uncleanness, nor in guile, but as we were allowed of Yahuwah to be put in trust with the Besorah, even so we speak, not as pleasing men, but Yahuwah, which tries our hearts. For not at any time use we flattering words, as you know, nor a cloak of covetousness, Yahuwah is witness, nor of men saw we glory, neither of you, nor yet of others, when we might have been burdensome as the apostles of Mashiach. But we were gentle among you, even as a nurse cherishes her children. So being affectionately desirous of you, we were willing to have imparted unto you, not the Besorah of Yahuwah only, but also our own souls, because ye were dear unto us. For you remember, brethren, our labor and travail, for laboring night and day, because we would not be chargeable unto any of you. We preached unto you the Besorah of Yahuwah. You are witnesses, and Yahuwah also, how we preached unto you the Besorah of Yahuwah, purely and uprightly, and were without blame among you that believe. As you know how we exhorted and comforted and charged every one of you, as a father does his children, that ye will walk worthy of Yahuwah, who has called you unto his kingdom and glory. For this cause also thank we Yahuwah without ceasing, because when ye received the word of Yahuwah which ye heard of us, ye received it not as the word of men, but as it is in truth, the word of Yahuwah, which effectually works also in you that believe. For ye, brethren, became followers of the called out assemblies of Yahuwah, which in Yahu are in Mashiach Yahusha. For ye also have suffered like things of your own countrymen, even as they have of the Yehudim, who both killed Adonai Yahusha and their own prophets, and have persecuted us, and they please not Yahuwah, and are contrary to all men, forbidding us to speak to the other nations that they might be saved, to fill up their sins always, for the wrath has come upon them to the uttermost. But we, brethren, being taken from you for a short time in presence, not in heart, endeavored the more abundantly to see your face with great desire. Wherefore we would have come unto you, even I, Paul, once and again, but Satan hindered us. For what is our hope, or joy, or crown of rejoicing? Are not even ye in the presence of our Adonai, Yahusha HaMashiach, at his coming? For ye are our glory and joy. Wherefore, when we could no longer forbear, we thought it good to be left at Athens alone, and sent Timotheus, our brother, and minister of Yahuwah, and our fellow laborer in the Besor of Mashiach, to establish you and to comfort you concerning your belief, that no man should be moved by these afflictions, for yourselves know that we are appointed thereunto. For even when we were with you, we told you before that we should suffer tribulation, even as it came to pass, and you know. For this cause, when I could no longer forbear, I sent to know your belief, lest by some means the tempter have tempted you, and our labor be in vain. But now, when Timotheus came from you unto us, and brought us good news of your belief and love, and that you have good remembrance of us always, desiring greatly to see us, as we also see you. Therefore, brethren, we were comforted over you in all our affliction and distress by your belief. For now we live, and ye stand fast in Yahuwah. For what thanks can we render to Yah again for you? For all the joy, wherewith we joy for your sakes before Yahuwah, night and day, praying exceedingly that we might see your face, and might perfect that which is lacking in your belief. Now, Yahuwah himself and our Father, and our Adonai, Yahusha HaMashiach, direct our way unto you. And Yahuwah make you to increase and abound in love one toward another, and toward all men, even as we do toward you, to the end he may establish your hearts unblameable in holiness before Yahuwah, even our Father, at the coming of our Adonai, Yahusha HaMashiach, with all his kodoshim. Furthermore, then we beseech you, brethren, and exhort you by Adonai Yahusha, that as ye have received of us, how ye ought to walk and to please Yahuwah, so ye would abound more and more. For ye know what commandments we gave you by Adonai Yahusha. For this is the will of Yahuwah, even your sanctification, that ye should abstain from fornication, that every one of you should know how to possess his vessel in sanctification and honor, not in a passionate lust, even as the other nations which know not Yahuwah, that no man go beyond and defraud his brother in any matter, because that Yahuwah is the avenger of all such, as we also have forewarned you and testified. For Yah has not called us unto uncleanness, but unto holiness. He therefore that despises not man, but Yahuwah, who has also given unto us his Ruach HaKodesh. But as touching brotherly love, ye need not that I write unto you. For ye yourselves are taught of Yahuwah to love one another. And indeed, ye do it toward all the brethren which are in all Macedonia. But we beseech you, brethren, that ye increase more and more, and that ye study to be quiet, and do your own business, and to work with your own hands, as we commanded you, that ye may walk honestly toward them that are without, and that ye may have lack of nothing. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Yahusha died and rose again, even so, them also which sleep in Yahusha will Yahuwah bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of Yahuwah, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of Yahuwah shall not prevent them which are asleep. For Yah himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the shofar of Yahuwah, and the dead in Mashiach shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds, to meet Yah in the air, and so shall we ever be with Yahuwah. Wherefore comfort one another with these words. But of the times and the seasons, brethren, ye have no need that I write unto you. For yourselves know perfectly that the day of Yahuwah so comes as a thief in the night. But when they shall say, peace and safety, then sudden destruction comes upon them, as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape. But ye, brethren, are not in darkness, that the day should overtake you as a thief. Ye are all the children of light, and the children of the day. We are not of the night nor darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep, as do others, but let us watch and be sober. For they that sleep, sleep in the night, and they that be drunken, are drunken in the night. But let us, who are of the day, be sober, putting on the breastplate of belief and love, and and for a helmet, the hope of Yeshua. For Yahuwah has not appointed us to wrath, but to obtain Yeshua for our Adonai, Yahusha HaMashiach, who died for us, that whether we wake or sleep, we shall live together with him. Wherefore, comfort yourselves together and edify one another, even as also ye do. And we beseech you, brethren, to know them which labor among you and are over you in Yahuwah, and admonish you, and to esteem them very highly in love for their work's sake, and be at peace among yourselves. Now we exhort you, brethren, warn them that are unruly, comfort the feeble-minded, support the weak, be patient toward all men. See that none render evil for evil unto any man, but ever follow that which is good, both among yourselves and to all men. Rejoice evermore, pray without ceasing, in everything give thanks. For this is the will of Yahuwah in Mashiach Yahusha concerning you. Quench not the Ruach, despise not prophesying, prove all things, hold fast that which is good. Abstain from all appearance of evil, and Yahuwah Shalom sanctify you wholly. And I pray to Yahuwah that your whole Ruach and soul and body be preserved blameless unto the coming of our Adonai, Yahusha HaMashiach. Faithful is he that caused you, who also will do it. Brethren, pray for us. Greet all the brethren with a holy kiss. I charge you by Yahuwah that this sefer be read unto all the holy brethren. The grace of our Adonai, Yahusha HaMashiach, be with you. Amen.